can choose between these names, Ned, Nigel, and the last one, Nimbus. Yeah, Ned, Nigel, and Nimbus. Cast your vote right now on our website, WUSA9.com. Two brothers originally from Southern Maryland are celebrating a big win tonight. Brothers Osborne took home the Academy of Country Music Award for Vocal Duo of the Year.
What is happening right now? This is amazing. We have the best seats in the house. I don't even know how we even got invited to sit up front. Our parents are here tonight. I want to thank them because honestly, they believed in us from the time we were babies.
God bless country music!
Go Southern Maryland. The duo has been nominated in this category every year since 2015. This is the first time they've won. Well, you know, tomorrow's the day Nats fans have been waiting for, the home opener, with everything you need to know if you're heading to Nats Park.
Mic check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Thank you.
Now, WUSA 9 Game On Sports with Frank Hanrahan, brought to you by Xfinity.
Almost there. Nats opening day is tomorrow right here on WUSA 9, facing the Miami Marlins. You know, the Nats, of course, defending NL East champs, so the expectations once again are very high, as they say the ceiling is the roof for this ball club. First pitch tomorrow, again at 1 o'clock. Steven Strasburg gets a start for D.C. All right, Caps getting a big win on the road, holding off a team that is chasing them in the division in Columbus. 3-2 the final. A lot of scraps in this game. All that matters is the Caps closer to clinching the division with the win. Wizards going for the series sweep of the Golden State Warriors. Not going to happen when you give up 139 points. Wizards close a five-game roadie losing a Golden State 2-3 record and have lost three straight. They're back home, though, for Charlotte on Tuesday night. And coming up on Game on Overtime, we preview the men's national title game, UNC versus Gonzaga, and we get you set for Arena League Football, Washington Valor, first ever game this Friday night. The head coach of the Valor stops by to talk about the team. Looking forward to it.
I love it. What a packed game on. And tomorrow's a big day. You want to watch everything here on WSA 9. You can get updates anytime on our app. And, of course, the best show ever, Game on Overtime. It's next. Why would you go?
Guy,
where would you go? Don't go anywhere. Good night.
Mic check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Is Game On Overtime.
Sends this one right field.
Play ball! Nationals are back, kicking off another season with expectations very high again. So will this finally be the season that they break through in the playoffs? We'll discuss.
Regional champion.
And then there were two. Gonzaga, North Carolina for the men's title in college basketball. We break down the matchup. Capitals are headed to the playoffs, but still a lot to play for, including a big one against Columbus tonight. All that and much more as Game On Overtime starts right now.
The Los Angeles Dodgers are headed to Chicago.
It still stings, doesn't it? Nationals falling to those Dodgers in the playoffs last fall. The Nats will try to make 2017 the year, and it starts tomorrow. It's already opening day. Hey there, welcome inside Game On Overtime. I'm Frank Hanrahan. Big show for you tonight, and we start with baseball. The boys of summer are back, and they spring into action with the Marlins tomorrow at 1 o'clock right here on WSA9 down at Nats Park. You know, there's nothing quite like opening day. You got a clean slate, a chance to do something special. And this year, the Nationals have the talent once again to do just that. Now, all they got to do is go out and do it.
I think we have a great group of guys, you know, just like last year. You know, we have all the pieces there to do it. It's just a matter of executing.
We know we got a talented group. We know we got the core here to be able to win and win a bunch of ball games. And, you know, we understand that the rest of the division in the NL East is very talented as well, and that it's going to be a fight the whole year.
Hopefully we'll be a lot happier at the end of this year than we were last year. And it was a good year, but we'd like to have a great year.
Steven Strasburg gets a start on opening day for the Nationals. This will be his fourth start, in fact, on opening day for the Nats. Good sign is that the Nats have not lost an opener when Strasburg starts. Now, despite missing the last part of the 16 campaign due to injury, Strasburg says he's ready to go.
It's, you know, game one of 162 and hopefully more. But, you know, spring has come to a close. No more trying to work on things and, you know, mess with new pitches maybe. So now it's go time. It's time to compete.
Steven Strasburg, we hope he's ready to go against the Miami Marlins. Danny Ruye is always ready to go. 106.7 The Fan, Granddaddy Show, 10 to 2 weekdays. You ready for some baseball, my friend?
I got that itch.
I
didn't really feel real in January and February when they were at spring training for a while. The dog days kind of ensued, but now is the time. I am ready for it. I got a fever. The only cure is opening day tomorrow.
Steven Strasburg gets the baseball. A little bit undersold, I think, during this offseason was his health. Apparently, he's 100% ready to go.
Listen, it's scary. It is a scary situation because when the initial diagnosis, you fear the worst. He's got some of the same symptoms as guys that need Tommy John surgery. And not to get too medical on folks, but it's basically, if you've got a problem in your dining room, that's what the Tommy John surgery it requires, right, to fix that. This is a problem with the front door. It's not the dining room, but it's right next to the dining room. It's an issue. It's something that is kind of a warning sign there. It's a precursor oftentimes to that TJ surgery. So he feels like he's going to throw less sliders. He's going to throw from the stretch, help streamline his mechanics a little bit. It's one of those things where maybe if he thinks it works, it works. So we will see how that sort of plays out. He started three opening days, and that's a one all three.
Bryce Harper, disappointing year a season ago. He has got to be obviously better for a team that won the NL East, for a team that lost in five games to the LA Dodgers. Good things happened last year when he was not so good. So that's a good thing for this team moving forward to expect a better season from him.
Trey Turner was incredible, and that was a godsend for the Nationals. Daniel Murphy, every time he touched the baseball, it was a base hit, basically. Those guys are going to regress. That happens. That's the sport. Bryce Harper, if you average last season and two seasons ago as MVP year, this is a productive, really, really good offense for the Nationals. Spring training, he has looked spectacular. Locked in, mechanically very sound, very comfortable, his head still not trying to do too much. His natural ability is so profound, it's so once in a generation. If he's healthy, he can have a season similar to what he did a couple years ago. And I think he's in tune for one of those. Hopefully, again, it's about health, Frank.
Daniel Murphy was what, the runner-up for MVP last year? The runner-up for the MVP, first year with the Nationals, can we expect the same from him this year?
340 and change is a tall ask for anybody. Again, every pop-up fell in between three guys, every ground ball, right, you know, it was navigating its way like Magellan through the ocean. But I think ultimately, if you settle into that 315 range with 20-plus home runs and drive the baseball on occasion, which I think he will, he had a kind of a career change a couple of seasons ago, end of the year with the New York Mets. And that ultimately has kind of sustained. Everyone thought it was fluky, including his own team, the Mets, by the way, said, this playoff run is nice. He's not going to keep doing that. Well, he did exactly that coming here to Washington. Again, 340 and change is probably too much. For 315, settling into that type range with an OPS around 9, I think you can expect that from Daniel Murphy. Silver Slug nominee at second base.
Real quick, your prediction for 2017. What's the record? How far do they go this year?
I think the Mets are terrific, and this division is better than it's been. Some of these teams that are rebuilding, they're almost built now, and the Marlins, their opponent, is going to be, they'll be better than they were this past year. I think the Nats are in that 91-92 win range. It's going to be a coin toss with them or the Mets who wins the division, but I think both are playoff caliber teams.
A lot to prove again for the Nationals this year. year, even though they had a very good 2016. This is a big, big season ahead for them. It all starts tomorrow against the Miami Marlins opening day from Nats Park. I'll see you there tomorrow, Danny.
You got
Thank
it, buddy.
You, my friend.
Can't wait.
Do not forget to use hashtag NatsOn9 tomorrow opening.